To this very important announcement by not just myself, a couple other people from concerned citizens of St. Petersburg, as well as Stop the Lens. We support them, they support us. What we all mutually support is the truth. This is a very important election. More than 60,000 ballots have already been mailed last week. And our biggest concern is that voters make the right decision based on facts and the truth, not based on twisted political agendas by the mayor, by any city employee, council member, or any outside group that purports to be portraying the truth. Many people have received pieces in the mail, including from the mayor, and from some new group which just started a few weeks ago, which represents that, and there's going to be others that will elaborate in greater detail on this, that nobody is paying a dime in St. Petersburg or Pinellas County for any new pier development outside of the downtown TIF district. That absolutely is a falsehood. That's why I got started in Forum Vote on the Pier 3 years ago this month. I am passionate about the truth. I'm passionate about voters having the opportunity to make their right decision based on facts, not based on political twisted agendas, whether it's from an outside group or from internally from City Hall, from council members or the mayor that have their own political agenda. I started this political committee in November 5th of 2010 to garner the support of the voters, if in fact that could happen, to put the referendum question on the ballot if voters would like to preserve and refurbish the existing pier or demolish it. We went for 20 and a half months. To date, as of today, we have collected more than 24,000 petitions from city voters. It's my understanding concerned citizens with Stop the Lenses can collected more than 20,000, close to 21,000, which translates into essentially 45,000 petitions have been signed by people with their own opinions that would simply like to be able to vote on what happens with the downtown waterfront. That's what I'm about. That's all I'm about. I can't even vote on it. I'm presently not a St. Petersburg resident. I am a Pinellas County taxpayer, and I'm very concerned about people having the opportunity to vote their decision based on the truth and not twisted political agendas. There's several flyers, brochures, websites, and now there's Build the Pier, Save the Pier. They're trying to, the last minute, last ditch effort here, to sway the voters by confusing them on calling the lens now the pier, when in fact in none of their material do they mention the word lens whatsoever. It's very disheartening, it's very sad. I felt that on behalf of the people that signed our petition, on behalf of the hundreds of volunteers through our 20 and a half month drive, as well as in respect to the volunteers for concerned citizens and Stop the Lens, that a couple of us come out vocally to establish the importance of this election. It's a 100+ year decision. It's $50 million of borrowed money that people need to get the facts. And with that, there's a couple of individuals I'd like to turn this over to so they can discuss in their own perspective and answer any questions you might have after they're done speaking.
Can I just ask you one quick question?
Yes.
I think you just said, do you think that there's an intentional effort there to kind of confuse voters, purposely to trick them?
It's a deliberate attempt by this new group that crawled out of the ground 4 or 5 weeks ago called Build the Pier. They're asking people to vote no to build the pier. The pier's already out there. If you're embarrassed that it's called the lens because the majority of the city doesn't support it, you own it. That's it. The lens, you own it if you love it or you hate it. But to confuse the public at this critical juncture is irresponsible. It's a blatant disregard for the intelligence of the average voter. And voters need the truth in order to make their own educated decision. Does that answer your question? Okay, with that, I'd like for a second to turn it over to Council Member Newton I'd like to introduce him because since day one, when I discussed forming Vote on the Pier, and I didn't know Councilman Newton before all this started, maybe a month before it, and I remember the day as if it was yesterday when he notified me that the folder was sitting on a seat at 8:15 in the morning, that they were going to vote to demolish the pier without so much as a public hearing, let alone a referendum, and he was ready to cry. I mean, I don't even know the man, but I could feel it in his voice. He just was disappointed of something that was real important to this city that was going so bad. And with that, I'd like to let Councilmember Newton say a few words.
Thank you, Tom. I'm not as tall, so I got to adjust this. First of all, I want to thank all of you for coming out and to continue to cover this. You know, I started on this journey way back in 2010 by myself. You know, and it's been a tough journey. But, you know, somewhere along the line, I realized that when I got elected to office that we as elected officials are stewards of the taxpayers' assets and money. We don't own it. It belongs to you, the people. So if we decide to get rid of or tear down a historical iconic asset, then you should at least have the opportunity to vote on it just like you voted us in the office. And that was not being allowed. And as you can see from all the shenanigans that went on up until today, I mean, it's a shame. You know, it's a shame. That's the best I can say. The people have elected you into office to try to be a representative of government by the people and for the people. And all this stuff that's going on, first you get the people to raise enough petitions that are certified by the supervisor of election. Then by a 6-2 vote, council suppresses those voters. Don't let them vote. Then we have to be sued, the city has to be sued by Ms. Kathleen Ford just to give the people an opportunity. Then you have to get another group to go out and work hard against people they elected to get more petitions. Over 40,000 petitions were signed, and over 23,000 voters signed both petitions. You know, so I mean, this is, I mean, all they ever want to do is vote on an asset that belongs to them. As to these efforts that are currently going on, they won't even own up to the lens. And these are the same people that have gotten to the ear of the people that you voted into office to not let you have a proper say or to fool you or trick you into voting for something you know nothing really about. The lens is what they wanted. The lens is on the ballot. The people have the right to vote on the lens. But even look at the question. I receive emails of seniors that are being confused, but they saw through a lot of the minutia and explained it to the rest of the seniors that they got yes if you want to cancel the Maltzan contract and no if you want to proceed and keep the lens. So it's like yes mean no and no mean yes. Sound like they think the voters are 3-year-olds, you know? So it started out from that alone. But all I can tell you is that everything that we put out from this office and everything the city that affiliated with should be forthright and truthful. It was some direct questions asked yesterday in council by Mr. Ballard, and all he got was just, you know, a lot of shenanigans. I couldn't even get a direct answer. I asked him how much money we had on hand right now to build anything. And they said they don't know. We've been at this since 2010. They spent $3.9 million of your tax dollars that they won't get back. And they don't know how much money they got on hand. You don't know or you don't want to say. See, and it's like, again, we're stewards of the taxpayers' assets and money. But these deliberate campaigns to fool the voters by building the pier, how can you want to demolish the pier and build the pier? That don't make no sense. I mean, in itself, that don't even sound right. I mean, you already have a pier out there. So why you want to build a pier when you have a pier? What they want to build is the lens. But they're so embarrassed they won't even mention the lens by name because surveys have shown time and time again that the voters want to say. The last time we did something this monumental and shut the voters out was building Tropicana Field or Florida Suncoast Dome or the Thunder Dome. It was 30-40% of the taxpayers' money used and the people didn't get an opportunity to vote. But right now we shelter the massive debt that's on that Tropicana Field belongs to us, even on the verge of a team that's trying to look elsewhere to play. So I think the people of St. Petersburg, if they're going to be on hook for the debt, they should have a right to know exactly what's going on, what it's going to cost them, and how long. This thing about a tax increment district and the funding is going to stay to help improve that district. And once that district improves over a 30-year period or whatever, it's going to go help the rest of the city. So the rest of the city is supposed to sit around and be in disarray and some of the areas blighted for 30 years until you get this done and then you move on with money and proceeds from that. Is that the rationale? Because that's what they're saying how it's going to work. And know that the debt service payments come from the general fund, which is excise taxes, property taxes, whatever we have in there to make those debt service payments. So yes, everybody will be paying and contributing to that. And that was some of the questions Mr. Ballard asked yesterday that I think legal came back to clarify at the end of the council meeting. But all I want is the people to know that if they're voting for, if they're voting yes on the ballot, that's to kill the contract. Yes means you don't want to go forward. Yes means you want to have a say on your waterfront. No means you want to let the city continue to spend your money. No means you want to build the lens, not a pier, the lens. So I thank everybody for coming out. I thank the media for at least trying to keep the misinformation down to a slight mumble, but it's appreciated and the voters need it. I get a lot of calls of people just confused. I got calls yesterday about what's this and what's that, because they don't know. I mean, they're doing a great job of confusing them, and that's what they want to do. So I appreciate you coming out today. I'll answer any questions I can if you have any.
Thank you, Wengay. I'm Bill Ballard. I'm president of Concerned Citizens of St. Pete. We're the organization that did the last petition drive and got the question on the ballot, should the city adopt a law, an ordinance, to direct the mayor to terminate the Maltzan design agreement for that project called the lens by the architect, called the lens by everybody until they realized the name had a stink around it. The question to which we're asking you to vote yes is $50 million, is it a good expenditure of $50 million of your tax money? By your, I mean every taxpayer in the city, regardless of whether you own property or just a renter and pay utility taxes, communication taxes, taxes on natural gas, and the whole host of hidden taxes that go into our general fund. Is it worth $50 million of those dollars to build the lens? Or can we do better for our waterfront with that $50 million? One of the better options is a reconsideration of what our old inverted pyramid has for us. We don't take in our organization a position on that, but our old pier deserves a chance to be studied independently to get real bids to see what can be done out there. So we are united with Tom Landon's group in giving our old pier that opportunity. The lie is out there that every dime of the $50 million is accounted for from taxes generated in the downtown area only. Not a penny comes from the rest of us in St. Pete. St. Pete has a highly acclaimed, and I think it's worth it, fiscal reporting system. And these are documents from that highly acclaimed fiscal reporting system. This is the downtown redevelopment district that is supposed to build whatever we build out there. Where does it get its money? Well, it gets $4.7 million from the general fund. The general fund is where public safety, fire safety, and all your basic governmental services come from. And another $3.5 million comes from the county. Wait a minute, where is this special earmarked, set aside money that we have been hearing about for the last 3 years? Folks, it doesn't exist. It isn't included in the county's, the city's accounting because it doesn't exist. This group, Build the Pier, is putting out a lie that they picked up from a prior group that the St. Pete Times picked up and published. Please, we want you to vote with the facts. If you love the lens, vote for the lens. But if you don't think it's worth your tax dollars for the next 20 years, vote yes. Vote yes to stop the lens.
Thank you, Bill Ballard. I'd next like to, where'd a bug go? Well, in light of keeping things moving, I have another person that would like to speak strongly on the issue. Okay, Bud Risser's here. He has, I'm sure, a few words he'd like to say as well. Thanks.
Thank you, Tom. We're losing the press here. I just explained to that guy he missed the important part. He missed the important part about the institutions that are lying to all of us. So let me try to hold your attention just for a minute. I'm responsible for the marketing of Concerned Citizens Group. I have over and over and over publicly said, if you've got any problem at all with any representation that we make, contact me and we'll review it and get back to you. In a year, I've received one comment. Now let's look at the other side of this. The two largest sources of lies and misinformation in this entire discussion are the staff of the city of St. Petersburg and the editorial board of the Tampa Bay Times, soon to be known as the All Intergalactic Times, I'm sure. Now, I'm accustomed to people not agreeing with me. Frankly, I kind of like that. I think that's how you ferret things out and get the truth. But we have noticed that, by that I mean we have sent notices to the city staff, to the mayor, and to the editorial board of the St. Pete Times, deliberately pointing out case by case by case where they are either, I'm going to use the lying word, I'm tired of being easy about this, where they lie in print about what's going on, and they do this, and they did it Sunday a week ago because they knew the ballots were being mailed out 2 days later, and you saw it, they published a whole full page editorial. And when I wrote them and I wanted to raise a couple questions, I was told, you know, get this, we normally don't publish letters to the editor based on fact. Now, I don't know what to make of that. So in my recent letter to Mr. Tim Nickens, I did not allege that they had mistreated the facts. I treated it as a misstatement. And I could only speak to one of the 14 things that I found wrong with that editorial because I had to submit it in less than 300 words. As far as the city is concerned, they have had on their website, on and off the whole year, factual misrepresentations. And those got picked up by the WOW group and publicized. And now they've been picked up again by this new group and sent out in their flyer. And it's the old story that Samuel Clemens talked about, their lies and their damn lies. And if you repeat a lie often enough, people begin to believe it. Well, let me set the record straight on a couple of things. First of all, Bill talked about who pays for this. Let me make this clear. This is going to be true for anything we do out there, whether it's refurbish the old pier or build a new pier or whatever. It's going to be true for all of these. But the point is, every taxpayer, fee payer, anybody that does business in Pinellas County is going to be repaying bonds. And it's the bonds that pay for this project or any other project we do. I didn't have enough words in my letter to the editor to say it isn't about that. It's about whether or not you want to borrow $50 million to build the lens. We're going to borrow money at some point to do something. We want a pier. We want the best pier that this city can have. And the lens is not it. So the real question is, does it make sense to borrow that $50 million to build something that 3/4 of the people don't want to have built? I have no idea where the St. Pete Times is coming for that. I'm going to continue to call them the St. Pete Times. They have been rabid. I've lost count. There have been at least 25 slanted news articles or editorials that are against us. And even when we tried to have a compromise meeting that Carl Nurse put together where we could meet with the city staff and clean up some real important issues, they belittled that. I'm sorry. The city council, with the exception of two members, refused to put an item on the ballot a year ago that would have resolved this. That's the very same city council who I think never read the Pier Task Force report, because the lens does not speak to almost anything that was put in the Pier Task Force report I have been asking at every public event that I can say, read the damn report for yourself. You can get there on the city's website. And if you don't want to read the whole thing, I've told you which pages to read. It's basically the executive summary and the recommendations. And you go to the recommendations that peer task force put together, and you tell me how many of those elements are in the lens. And oh, by the way, there are no air-conditioned restaurants on that thing. Not today.
The
Pier Task Force said 25,000 square feet of restaurant space, okay? With a minimum of 3 restaurants. And I'm off, this isn't a quote, but I'm real close. 3 restaurants. One, a quick serve restaurant. One, a beach bar style restaurant. And one, a gourmet restaurant at a minimum. I do not see any of that on the lens. Now they'll say, oh, they're gonna build one on the land side. Well, you built one on the land side today. It would be nice if you did so in concert with the land use plan that we're working up for our city right now. But there's no restaurant out there, none. There's no air conditioning. Well, maybe you don't mind going out there and eating your food when it's hot like this right now. But the minute that 4:30 thunderstorm comes up with its high winds and it's blowing rain and it's lightning, where are you going to go? The Times has repeatedly said 5 years of hard work. Well, it's true. And we're saying go back to the Pier Task Force. That took up the first 3 years, and we think if that city council had not ignored that task force report for an entire year, then we would not be having this pig today. If they'd taken that task force and run with it, I think we would have had a good solution. The last thing I want to bring up. Oh, you're going to cut me off. Doggone it.
I'm so sorry. We'd like to get you on the news.
You're going to miss the test. Look, the biggest turnout for a primary election like this in recent years is 35,000 people. Anybody know how many people have already voted? 10,000. 10,000 have already voted. We're going to have, I think, a record election. And hopefully all those people that have signed the petitions that the Tom's group put together and our group have put together are going to blow the roof off of this thing. Yes. So get out and vote, and vote yes to stop the lens. Thank you.
Thank you.
And we have another guest here that I'd like to say a few words. She's been very passionately supportive of my efforts from day one on creating Vote on the Pier and the original petition, and that's Kathleen Ford. Thanks for coming, Kathleen.
Thanks. Thank you, and I'd like to thank everybody who's still hanging around. This is an important issue, and it's important for a lot of reasons, because I think it shows our local government's total disregard of the citizens, and I just don't think that's right. And not only do I think it's not right, I think our charter says it's not right. And don't believe Mr. Foster when he says he's in favor of giving folks a vote on the pier, because he could do that today. He told his staff to go ahead and put something on the ballot that asks voters whether they approve of demolition of the inverted pyramid. But he's not doing that. Instead, Mayor and his staff are filing a response to my appeal, and that will be decided by a court of appeals as to whether or not the citizens of St. Pete are entitled to a vote on whether or not the city can completely destroy 78,000 square feet of incredible commercial space. I am very much pleased by Stop the Lens's incredible effort. It was really difficult, and I urge you voters to look carefully at your ballot. Vote yes to terminate the Maltzan contract. Vote no if you want the city to build the lens. But let me suggest to you that we have not received enough information to tell us exactly how much that lens would cost. And I have some very serious concerns about the ongoing subsidy that would be required, because the materials have changed. And yes, Mr. Ballard, you're right. Every taxpayer is impacted by our decision here in St. Pete, especially when we borrow money or we put it in, use those funds and keep them in one particular district that in fact impacts the rest of the city of St. Pete. Finally, I'd like to point out that it is an important issue, that there are other issues on the ballot, and I encourage you to look at all of the candidates and talk to all of the candidates to find out where they stand, because this, folks, is a real litmus test. It's a real litmus test on leadership for your local government. Do they really want to listen to you, the people, or not? And again, I thank Tom Lambdon and all the volunteers for Vote on the Pier, and Mr. Risser and Mr. Ballard and all the folks who worked on Stop the Lens, because you're doing what we see is important in America, and that is giving the citizens the right to vote on those issues that are so very important to them. Again, thank you everybody for coming out this afternoon.
If anybody else has any questions or anything, now's the time, or we're gonna wrap it. Thanks everybody for coming out, and don't forget to get out and vote. It's very important. Thanks. Yeah.